Welcome back to MacMimic, where you can simply view, imitate, replicate, and get on with your day. If there is a specific issue for which you would like to see a video, please leave a comment. The title of this video is how to come close to right-click and create a new text file. What I mean by that is that most likely you came here because you are used to specific behavior in a certain operating system when it comes to creating text files, and now you would like to replicate this on your Mac. You will have noticed that macOS Finder does not natively offer an option to create a new text document by right-clicking in an empty space, like in, yes, Windows Explorer. However, you can mimic this behavior by using a simple workaround and possibly even improve on it. There are paid third-party solutions in Apple's App Store that might offer more features, but you can do a lot with just macOS to get similar functionality to Windows for creating new text files. So in short, here in Finder, I would like to have the possibility to quickly add a new text document, just like there is the option to create a new folder. Let's get started by opening Automator through Spotlight or through Launchpad. If it doesn't show up straight away, simply click the Automator icon in the dock. Select Quick Action and click Choose. Under Workflow Receives Current, select No Input from the list, and under In, select Finder, because this is where you want this functionality to work. You can leave all of the other fields and selections. From the list on the left, manually find Run AppleScript or search for it in the search bar at the top. Click it and drag it over to the right part of the screen. This will open a default AppleScript template, clearly indicating where your code needs to go. Simply copy and paste or type it if you want to build the script. For your convenience, there is a link in the description of this video to the code I am using here. This code will create a new file with the name newtextdocument.txt, exactly like this is done on Windows. Just adjust this to your needs. Now save the script. I'm simply using the descriptive name newtextdocument for easy reference. Go back to Finder, and you will see that right-clicking still doesn't list the required option. It works a little bit different. Scripts that you have created will actually show up in the Finder menu under Services. Select New Text Document, and a new empty text document will now be created. But we can do a little bit better by assigning a keyboard shortcut to the script. From the Finder menu, select Services, and then Services Settings. This opens up the keyboard shortcuts in System Settings. Alternatively, go straight to System Settings, and then Keyboard, Keyboard Shortcuts, and click Services. Open the General section, and there you will find the script New Text Document. There is currently no keyboard shortcut assigned. Click it and type your shortcut on the keyboard. I am going with Ctrl-Option-N for new file, but you could also use Ctrl-Shift-N or something else. Click Done once finished. In the earlier menu option, you can now see the assigned keyboard shortcut, just like this is the case for native macOS options. Now open Finder and press your new key combination to test it. A new text file should appear. You could stop right here, but there is a problem with the current script. It only creates the file newtextdocument.txt and does nothing else. So if the file is already there and I run the script again, we get a very expected and predictable error. The operation can't be completed because there is already an item with that name. Let's adjust the script so that the second new text file will get a sequence number. Once again, a link is in the description of this video. The default name is again newtextdocument.txt, and the counter starts at 1. I have used the underscore as the separator character, and adjust all of this to your liking. Now the script attempts to create a file newtextdocument.txt, and if this file already exists in the target folder, it adds and increments a sequence number until it finds a name that doesn't already exist. without running into any errors. That's it. Hope it helped, and if it did, please like the video and keep it up. Until next time, bye!